What a warm welcome back to Bangkok as we prepare for our second match on court number two on this, the opening day of the YONEX Thailand Open. The officials are on the court and we have an intriguing women's singles coming up. Michelle Lee, seeded eight, up against Cheung Ngan of Hong Kong, China. See, just 27 minutes that opening match, the mixed doubles. This might be a bit of a more of a drawn out affair. Here's how it all fits into the draw. We'll see that bottom match, Tun Jung versus Sun, later on this morning. And that's who the winner of that match will play, either Lee or Cheung. Tsai Su Ying of Chinese Taipei, singles, the top seed, also in this Michelle part of the draw. Canada.
Versus Cheung Ngan from Hong Kong, China. Umpire Latif Johari from Indonesia.
That's Michelle Lee. And Cheung Ngan following on behind her. There's Cheung. Well, didn't look to be too much ring rust, did there, for Chang and Un in that opening mixed double. So I wonder whether Michelle Lee will look similarly impressive. Just so strange, isn't it, with no handshakes. It obviously it's the right thing to do. No. 29 now, Michelle.
What?
She's won five of the six meetings between the two.
Like what you just, it's just so, that side.
So let's give you a little look at both these players then, starting with Michelle Lee, who's seeded 8 for this tournament and ranked 10th in the world. Born in Hong Kong, of course, as you see there, but she moved to Canada when she was just 6 years of age. Commonwealth Games champion from 2014. I was there for that tournament in Glasgow. 7 years ago now, wow. Twice winner of the Macau Open. Overcome a load of injuries as well in her career, Michelle Lee, and there's her opponent, Cheung Ngan. 27 years of age, so a couple of years younger than Michelle. But she's pretty experienced. She's played in World Junior Championships, Uber Cup, Asian Games. And she won her first tournament, international tournament in Austria some 6 years ago. She's got to various other semi-finals at similar events, but obviously you're ranked 30. It's always a step up when you play a player in the top 10. Abdul Latif Kahari from Iran is in the chair. From Indonesia, I beg your pardon. Mansoor Sadat Jashian from Iran is the service judge.
Ready to play.
So we'll let the umpire perform the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Michelle Lee, Canada. And on my left, Cheung Ngan, Hong Kong, China. Michelle Lee to serve, level, play.
So first look at the world number 10 in 2021, Michelle Lee serving.
Service over, one love. Two love.
On court one, mixed double. Half is five.
That came right out the middle of Lee's racket.
And one, two. From Indonesia. Versus.
All the coaches, as well as the TV crew and such, wearing masks, mandatory.
2-0.
Error of judgment from Cheung.
Reza Roshan Homi from Iran. Service judge. Emmanuel Kamui Sile from Botswana.
A lovely shot from Lee.
3-2.
Well judged again by the Canadian. Some of those clears giving Cheung a problem early on here. Straightforward leave.
5-2.
There's an element at the moment of Michelle Lee just toying with Cheung Ngan Yi, bringing her forward with the drop shots, pushing her back with the clears. Oh. Well, that ends a run of six straight points.
Service over. 3-6.
Just got too much angle on. That's always going to beat the sideline.
5-6.
So after 6 points in a row for Lee, now 4 in a row for Cheung, and we're back on level terms again.
All.
So used to going to the service judge to change the shuttle. Great decision to play that from Lee. That's nicely judged drop shot from Cheung Ngan Yi there.
7-6.
Well, needs to stop the rot. That's 6 points on the spin. For the Hong Kong Chinese woman. Just a little casual again from Lee.
9-6.
Oh, how well has she started?
10-6.
Excellent. That's much better from Lee. Really asserted herself.
Service over.
In that rally.
7-10.
She realises that she's in a match here. I've always thought that Michelle Lee is the kind of player that can win points in clusters, also do the same, lose points in bunches. That was long, and she's back within a point.
9-10.
Miscue, so couple of point advantage for Cheung.
11-9
at the mid game interval.
Part 2, 20 seconds. Part 2, 20 seconds.
First game, the first part of which swung one way and then the other. But it's anyone's here, just a point in it.
Service over, 10-11.
And Lee, as we showed you at the start, it's a pretty good record against this woman. 5 wins in 6 matches that they've played. Started well here though.
Service over, 12-10.
Another error from the Canadian.
13-10.
And not surprising that, you know, after so little competitive play in 2020, it'll take them a little while to just get themselves attuned again to badminton at this level. Doesn't matter how much your practice. Nothing is a substitute for actual match action.
Serve server, 11-13.
Well, she's hit a couple of those long, but not that time. Comfortably inside the line. So finally, she gets herself level again. First time since it was 6 points apiece. Point that she totally dominated. But you just feel so far there've been pretty much an equal number of winners and errors from Michelle Lee. That's why, or one reason why Cheung's right in this, in addition to the fact that she's played well herself. Oh, that's a lovely angle. Really good placement from Lee.
14-13.
Well, it does seem it's either feast or famine at the moment for the Canadian.
Serve,
that was
14-all.
Long to the point at which Cheung didn't really have to think about letting it go. That's lovely play from Cheung. It was actually a pretty good get by Lee, but clearly powerless.
15-14.
Good block, but nowhere to go after that.
Thank you. Serve, 15-all.
Well, this is just how you want it, isn't it? I mean, who would have a clue how this first game's going to end? Both women having moments of inspiration, both making a few errors as well. Makes it intriguing. Well, a hand of apology, but she'll be pretty happy with that.
16,
Michelle Lee.
15.
Net cord effectively didn't give Cheung any chance to win the point. Just the wrong side of the line.
You want challenge? Yes, we have challenge.
And she's going to challenge it. And I think that's fair enough. I mean, it's late. It's late in the game. That looked close. May have just caught the line, but absolutely no harm in double checking with Hawkeye. Each woman has two challenges per game. And it was a good challenge. Well out.
challenge unsuccessful, one challenge remaining.
That's my mistake, I beg your pardon. Why I thought it was called in, and of course it wasn't.
So 17-15.
Now, big point coming up. If Lee can get to 18-15. Oh, that's a lovely shot from Cheung. She's played a few of those.
Service
just
order.
Deceivedly, and by the time she
16,
reacted to it,
17.
It was too late. Just clipped the frame of the racket, but it landed in anyway, so it didn't really matter.
Serve server. 18-16.
I think she was in two minds about whether to leave that, Cheung. In the end, I think she had 16. To play it. And into the tram lines it went. Lee a couple of points away from securing this opening game. Once again, this deceptive little shot has Lee scrambling and struggling.
19.
And Cheung still fighting in this opening game. Good get, excellent reactions.
Service over.
Three game points for Michelle Lee.
Game point 17.
And it was wide. So game. The opening game to Lee, 21-17. Not
first
without
game,
a few alarms, you'd have to say. But she hung
17.
Tough. And just about got the better of Cheung in that opener. But still maybe plenty more in this match. 21-17, the opening game for the Canadian.
Court 2, 20 seconds. Court 2, 20 seconds. Second game. Level. Play.
So first game where Lee at 1.16 straight points, and Cheung won 8. It ended up relatively tight. Still think there might be a bit more in this match. judgment from Lee.
Server, one left. Service server, one all.
Good pressure from Cheung. I think she's got to do that. We can't rely on unforced errors from Lee. And she looked at her best in that opening game when she was being proactive and attacking. Lovely touch from Lee at the net.
Service over to all.
Well, that was wonderfully placed.
3-2.
Let's have a look at this. It's a little floated backhand. An excellent rally. Pity it was ended by an error rather than a winner.
3-3. Jane Sutter.
Good judgment from Cheung.
4-3.
And a couple of times in the last few points where she's been uncertain whether to leave or play, made a late decision that was more decisive.
Oh.
And again.
5-3.
Well, I think both of them saw the funny side of this. It was almost like a afterthought. Just put it there and it happened to hit the middle of the racket, the shuttle, and it was fine. Perfectly legal. Well, should be cross about that. Having got that bonus point previously, that was careless from the Canadian.
4.
Just missed the sideline.
Serve server, 5-6.
Oh. Subtle stuff from the world number 10.
All.
Making her opponent scramble at the net there. Some excellent angles, just running her around.
All. 7-6.
That's twice in the last 3 points.
Service over, 7-7.
Well, there was a bit of anger in that. It really was after that service error.
Thank you. Service over. 8-7.
That's more like the Misha Lee we know.
9-7.
Looked really focused during that point. Set her up with a little drop shot and then from mid-court dispatched it.
Over.
It still feels like two steps forward and one back. Just a few more unforced errors creeping into Cheung's game than we saw in the opening game. It's a good leave, and it's a 3-point advantage at the mid-game interval for Michelle Lee.
Court 2, 20 seconds. Court 2, 20 seconds.
Clever from Michelle Lee. Don't think Cheung was expecting that little drop shot. Yeah, well set up by Cheung. She needed a confidence-building point
nine,
like that.
12. Change settle. Serve server. 13-9.
That looked a little tired, didn't it, from Cheung Ngan Yee? Just
9.
First time I've really noticed that. Suddenly she looks at the scoreboard, see she's 5 points adrift now in this second game. Well, when you're on top, you tend to get the breaks, the hand of apology after the net cord. That's well played.
Serve server. 10-15.
Versus Luis Enrique from Spain.
Server.
Again, Cheung paying the price for allowing Lee to play that shot at pretty close quarters. That's well out.
Serve server. 11-16.
She could win the next couple of points. That might just sow a few seeds of doubt in Lee's head. That is a very surprising
13-16.
Miss.
16.
Yeah, she's right back in this, and all of a sudden, 14, Lee looks the player under pressure. 16. This is a spirited little comeback here from Cheung. Great judgment again.
15-16.
We've seen Lee do this before. I don't know whether it's concentration or what, but just taking a foot off the gas here. Needed that.
Sarasota, 17-15.
Yeah, beautifully played down the line, just to give her
18,
a little bit of breathing space.
15.
Still in there punching, Cheung Ngan Yee. She knows she can still make things a little nervous here for Michelle Lee. 16-18.
Serve server, 19-16.
just hit the bottom of the tape.
Server.
Got there.
17,
early
19.
Enough, just a little indecisive from Lee. And Cheung making her work for this. And now, right in 18, the melting pot. You see from the body language, she's a little tense here. Cheung having got back to within a point. Well, she's going to challenge, but I think this is more in hope than genuine belief.
Out.
Dictated really by the state of the match. It looked long, it was called long, but Hawkeye will be the ultimate arbitrator of this. Oh, it caught the line. Wow. That is massive.
Correction in.
So 19 apiece now.
19 all. Play.
Well, that was called in. It's going to be challenged. I think it's going to be unsuccessful, this for Lee. It's almost, again, dictated to by the scoreline, and because she has two challenges in hand. But Cheung now, I think in a moment, is going to go favourite to level this match.
Correction.
Well, I need to go to the opticians, Sarasota, clearly. And it's a match point 20, for Michelle Lee.
Match point 19.
But just one.
Play.
That's a great leave. As it's always difficult when the ball's coming over your shoulder, the shuttle's coming over your shoulder like that.
Server.
And especially match point down, she knew she was wrong, and it was curtains. I think that's excellent judgment. You see the replay, easy to say it was some way wide, but not as easy as that. When you're back pedaling and the shuttle's coming over your left shoulder. 20 all. Well, she really had to earn that. Great chasing from Cheung, but in the end, nothing she could do about the winner, and a second match point for the Canadian.
20. Thank you. Quickly. Okay. Okay.
Can Lee finish the job this time? No, that's a stunning return.
Serve server, 21-0.
Well, full marks for effort for Cheung, scrambling around.
22.
Desperately
21.
Trying to get that back, but the upshot is a third match point for Michelle Lee.
Thank you.
She thought about challenging, changed her mind.
22.
So three match points gone. Just wonder now whether Lee's starting to have a few doubts about this, and you've had opportunities and failed to take them. Oh, it's good. Great reactions. Although Cheung will think that's an opportunity missed.
23-22.
So a fourth match point now for Michelle Lee. Well, finally, she gets the job done thanks to an error. 24-22. You wouldn't say that it's Michelle Lee at her brilliant best, but I'm sure she'll improve throughout the tournament and out for a long time, of course, without competitive action. And she just did enough to get the better of Cheung Ngan Yi. Gave her quite a few anxious moments. And that was the denouement, the error from the Hong Kong Chinese. So by a scoreline of 21-17, 24-22, 42 minutes on court, and it's Michelle Lee who advances into the next round.